This is Cheap Kairos, my completely free-to-play account that I am not allowed to spend any money on. My whole goal is to max out the account for free as fast as possible. Today is day 308, and thanks to a very special shooting Starr Drop event that's going on, I've got 6 Starr Drops from here and 6 Starr Drops in here, including 2 free legendaries that I'm all going to open up today. But first, I need to hop into my time machine and show you some clips that happened before today. It's day 302, we got a mythic. Oh, okay. It's day 305, I opened up an epic star drop and I got this player icon. There's also this free profile icon in the shop. That's nice. Oh, we got a mythic too. Legendary. Oh, we've got a legendary today. I was fully planning on not recording like at all today, but we keep getting stuff. Okay, new brawler. Wait, what is this? New skin. I get so confused because I've played all of the brawlers on my main account. I forget which brawlers that I have unlocked on this account. And I was like, I'm pretty sure I have Hank. What is this? Okay, it's a fine skin for a brawler. I don't really like playing very much, but it was a legendary and I'll take it. Oh, and we also got this player icon. That's why I started recording here, is because this player icon, I got it from a quest. So 3 player icons today. It's day 307. I just won the Halloween challenge. Look at that, 1,000 coins and this new player icon. Cool. We actually got a ton of different resources for this. Take a look at this here, okay? We got 250 credits, 100 chroma credits, 500 power points, 1,000 coins. That is insane. Not to mention all the tokens that we got right here. That is 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 bonus rewards. So that's an extra 250 coins, 100 power points, and 25 credits. Every little bit helps here, okay? And now we are back to day 308. Before I open these, we're going to show the completely random 6 star drops that I'll get from today. First box of the day is rare. I'm not typically going to show you guys the rare ones, but oh, do like me some epics. I also don't typically show you guys the epics either, but today's an exception. We've got 12 boxes to show you. We also got a rare and a super rare. And my teammate here just got Chester from a legendary star drop. Okay, here are my last 2 random star drops for the day. We got some, of course, double rares. So 4 out of 6 of my random ones were all rares. It makes sense. But we do have some guaranteed legendaries, so let's do them. First up, super rare. Oh, I just double tapped it. That was weird. Okay, super rare. Cool. And epic. Okay, that's what happens. Cool. Coins. To be expected. Another epic. Okay. More coins. Okay. That's to be expected. Epics, not a big deal. Want those resources. Mythic, though. Okay. Here we go. Mythic, give it to me. Oh! Oh, I just unlocked a new brawler! Frank! I literally thought it was going to be Caveman Frank, but I was like, I don't think I have Frank. Dude, I only have 1 more epic brawler to go. Let's go. And that was from the mythic. What am I going to get from the legendaries? Oh, wow. I'm super hyped about that. That just saved me 925 credits. And it's actually really funny because now Nani is my last one. And I was fully intending for Frank to be my last epic brawler. In fact, I'm going to unlock Nani before I unlock my super rare Tick. So I'll have all the epics before I have all of the super rare brawlers. That's actually really funny. Unless I happen to get Tick from a star drop, which could happen. Whew, legendary star drop just like that. That is exciting. Okay, what is it? Are you kidding me? I just... Double brawlers. Epic brawlers are completed before Tick. That is so funny. Holy cow, I can't even believe it. That is insane. Dude, what? Every single epic brawler is unlocked. So look at this. It's literally like, other than Tick, it's like legendary mythic, legendary mythic, legendary mythic. Wow, that is insane. I'm very pleased with that. But we still have 1 more legendary. Dude, if we got, I mean, it would be cool if we got a brawler other than Tick, but also, I would be happy with Tick. Let's see what we get here. Legendary. Come on. Come on. You know what? If you're going to get a Mortis pin, that's the one to get. We'll at least go ahead and equip that because, you know, I almost never play Mortis, actually. Wow, dang. So Frank and Nani, we're going to have to upgrade both of them. Okay, well, let's upgrade Frank and Nani to power 9. That's 7, 8, 9. Frank's better gadget. I like active noise cancellation a lot, but I don't know. 100% extra damage and pulls opponents towards him. I think that this is the better option. So we'll go ahead and grab that for Frank. Not going to be worrying about either star powers. I don't think that they're quite worth it where my account is at yet. And now we upgrade to Nani to power 9 as well. Boom, there we go. And I definitely think Return to Sender is the better option for Nani. So we'll go ahead and grab that. And it's going to be a while before I get a star power for her. Dang, two new brawlers from today. That is absolutely insane. Plus, in a couple of days, we're going to be getting Chuck as well. And Chuck is a lot of fun. So I'm really hyped for that. Today, I finished my matches for probably the last time playing Club League ever. I was able to get maximum club trophies, which usually happens. Not always, though. But they mentioned they're getting rid of Club League. So by the time that 2 weeks happen, we might have an update, and Club League as we know it might be just completely different or might not even ever exist again. I don't know. Also, I'm in this weird part of the season where I've already collected all the resources in the season except for credits, all the way up into the bonus rewards, and I've got 38 of them. There's 20 days left of the season. I am curious to see how many bonus rewards we can get, because this will probably be my record on the account ever, because I do actually have the Brawl Pass, which means that I get the Brawl Pass exclusive quests, and we're slowly burning through these token doublers ever since they decreased the drop rate for them in the Starr Drops. Overall though, pretty happy with today's progression. That's really exciting. We'll see you in a day or two. It is day 309. I just woke up to a mythic Starr Drop, and today is day 310, and Chuck is officially out for release. I can unlock him now, and I am 100% going to. Like, no questions asked. Chuck is so much fun, especially in heist. I want to play him on this account before he gets nerfed. So we are switching over to Chuck. We got 412 credits already going towards him, and all I got to do is unlock all these credits. But first, I got to get my daily Starr Drops in. I didn't think I was going to show them to you because I didn't think I'd get anything special, and honestly, that wasn't even special. Before we open up Chuck, I just realized we got another legendary Starr Drop thanks to the special event that was going on. It looks like the community just barely squeaked past another reward before it ended. So let's grab that legendary Starr Drop here. Okay, I'm excited. What's it gonna be here? Dang it, I already had a gadget on him. Ah! That's okay. Actually, it's really good for like Robo Rumble and boss fight, so you know what? Okay, there are worse gadgets that I could have gotten. But it is finally time to unlock Chuck. I have been looking forward to unlocking him on this account for so long. He was the newest brawler, and as soon as I saw him, I just thought he was going to be so much fun to play. So whether or not he's actually very competitive, which he is very competitive in Heist and Siege, but even if he wasn't, he's just so fun, and there's something really great and exciting about unlocking new brawlers just because they're fun. Chuck is unlocked. Oh, that is so great. Let's freaking go. Okay, and now we're unlocking Meg. I just selected a random legendary brawler. I don't know if I'll choose Meg or not. We got lots of time to decide. I mean, look at that. 3,800 credits plus whatever we've got going towards these bonus rewards, which by the end of the season, I don't know how much that'll be. As always, we're going to upgrade him to power 9. That is the point where like he's like decently easy to play and he's not that big of an issue, but you still get a decent power advantage over a lot of brawlers. I have a feeling I'm going to be facing off against a bunch of maxed out Chucks though, especially in heists where I'm going to be playing him because he's so much fun. I'm not even going to bother getting one of his gadgets, surprisingly. I'm going to the opposite of why I only have 4,000 coins. Pit stop did seem worth it, but I really need coins. And there are going to be some hypercharges releasing in this next update. So I'm just gonna wait, I guess. Now, interestingly enough, we had our last Club League ever, at least until it's reworked. We don't know what's going to happen. Maybe Club League will exist. Maybe it won't after this next update. I don't know. But it is not starting. The next Club League week is not going to start at all. So 940 club coins is what I'm left with. Now, in the past, I've always said that power points are more worth it because I was able to convert the power points to coins, but you can't do that anymore. And so now the best thing for me to do is to spend my club coins on whatever I need. And I have a massive imbalance where I have too many power points and too many coins because I did spend a bunch of my club coins on power points. And honestly, I'm kind of regretting that now because I need way more coins. Coins are like, I'm struggling for coins. So we're going to be spending these final power points on, or club coins on these. Otherwise, half of them would be spent towards coins and half of them would be spent towards power points. So we'll see what we get for these remaining club coins here. That was enough for me to purchase over 2,000 coins though. So that's actually really great. I'm still not going to be spending coins on star powers though. The truth is that most of the brawlers, their star powers just are not worth 2,000 points, at least not where my account is right now. I want to save those coins for the abilities that actually make a big difference, which are gadgets, hypercharges, and just upgrading brawlers. Also, just kind of an interesting note on where my account is at. trophy wise, I had kind of stopped trying to push my Brawlers to 500 trophies because it was becoming really time consuming. I now have a ton of Brawlers below 500 trophies, which is interesting. I'm kind of taking the more like relaxed approach where I'm just pushing Brawlers as much as I need to get my daily Starr Drops, which I think is a little bit more of a healthy way to play the account. I did some unhealthy grinds right when this series first started. But the thing is I'm still doing all of my quests. Oh! Oh, 15 battles with Chuck quests. I love those. I'm also getting my daily 200 battle tokens. Like, I'm not missing out on any progression, so I'm still going to be maxing out the account pretty much as fast as possible. What is really interesting to me, though, is that I'm starting to kind of see the end of the road. Like, there aren't that many Brawlers remaining for me to have all of the Brawlers unlocked, aside from the Chromatics. So honestly, it kind of feels like a new chapter on the account, where progression is slowing down, but not in a bad way because it's forcing me to spend my resources towards actually upgrading the Brawlers that I have. So let's just keep going. It is day 312. We have a Legendary here. That's right, we do. I would say I'm hoping for a new Brawler, but really, I'd like a free Hypercharge, please. Oh, that's a great one. I love this one. Squeak is literally one of my favorite Brawlers to play on the account right now, and I haven't maxed him out just because I haven't gotten to it yet. But this is the star power I would have wanted on him. So now I have this insane gadget, this great star power. I just have to increase him to level 11 now and like... Oh, that's exciting. I like how long it took for that to like process in my mind. Like, is this the one that I wanted? Like, what's going on right now? Day 314, we got a mythic here. Let's see what it is. Oh, I like fat stacks of coins very much. Day 315, we got a mythic. We got one more chance for legendary. Oh, look at that. I don't know what I want this to be, but I hope it's not a skin. Let's see what it is. It wasn't that. Yeah, I don't know if I'm going to use this very much. That's fine. Today is day 316. It is update day. We've got 25 days of free gifts, starting and ending with the legendary star drop. So let's go. Legendary star drop right here. Or regular. Rare. I'm very confused. Okay. Maybe it's not a legendary star drop. I don't know. But I'll for sure have a legendary at the end of this 25-day period. Also, thanks to the update, I was able to get this plant clown pin for following the link in Brawl Talk. And the remainder of my club coins were converted into coins and power points. There was a lot of issues with the loading of this update, so they actually did put in a free legendary star drop right in the shop. So we're going to grab this. Hopefully it is actually legendary. Okay, thank you. Let's see what we get here. It's 500 credits. I can't remember why it's 500 credits. I thought 500 credit drops from legendaries were because you have all the brawler. Oh, it's because I would have gotten a new brawler that was of a rarity that I have all of the brawlers for. So it was probably because I got all the epic brawlers and it would have been a new epic brawler. So that's cool. I mean, 500 credits going towards Meg, that's really awesome. Also, I love doing this as a free-to-play player, being like, look at all these cool new things that I could buy with gems, but I'm not able to because I don't have gems for 15 coins. Thank you. Every 15 coins is helpful. But what is really exciting, aside from all of these rides, there is the fact that we have the hypercharge unleashed, and all we have to do is activate hypercharge 15 times in this challenge to get a completely random free hypercharge. It's day 320. I know I haven't seen you guys in a few days and you were expecting me to do the hypercharge challenge, but it was not available. There were glitches. Anyway, I've got a mythic star drop here. We got three chances for legendary. Nope, looks like it is a mythic. I will take those coins. I need coins desperately. But the hypercharge event is back online and I've almost got it completed. I'll probably finish it up tomorrow. I'm really excited to see which one I get for free. I mean, most of the brawlers with hypercharge, I would be willing to max out. We'll see though. Oh, also we got some chroma credit jackpot. Okay, so this is weird. It's been 54 days since my last jackpot. It makes me wonder if maybe I miss one or something like that. I'm pretty sure that I check the shop every single day, but it is really annoying because for a while there, the shop has always had the yellow icon. So like I kind of got used to not always like going on it. So maybe I missed a jackpot or something, but either way, I got it today and I'm glad that it's the chroma credits because I could be wrong. I think it's going to take me longer to unlock all the chromatic brawlers than all the legendaries. We'll have to see though. Okay, it is day 321. We have completed the hypercharge challenge and that means, oh, this is cool. It's a hypercharge star drop. This is intense. Okay, what is it going to be? I really hope it's a good brawler. Okay, let's go. Let's go. I I mean, Pearl's great for solo showdown. She's actually really strong. So am I going to max her out though? You know what? Actually, yeah. Yeah, I am. She's really good. She's really good. Her Overcooked gadget recently got a little bit of a buff, but I still think she's going to be pretty strong. So I think that she is worth upgrading to level 11, especially considering the fact that it's really cheap for me to have another maxed out brawler with their hypercharge just by doing it. Her hypercharge isn't my favorite because her super can literally knock people outside of the burning area, but she does get an additional speed boost, damage boost, and shield boost while she has it. So it's worth it. I mean, it could have been Jackie, right? So we are going to max out Pearl. Was not expecting that, but that's okay. And honestly, I don't know which star power is the better option. I have a feeling in 3v3s, my heat's not going to be over 80% very often. So I'm going to go with heat retention. Honestly, this might be a mistake, but I think that it's a decent star power. Neither of them are like game breaking. And honestly, I probably wouldn't spend the 2000 coins on them just yet, except for the fact that she's my new maxed out brawler. I'm 100% getting her gadget charge gear for her, absolutely. And damage is pretty much always good. So we're going to grab that as well. Oh my gosh. And there goes all of my coins. I'm down to 650 coins. I've got 7,500 power points. But I now have 4 maxed out brawlers with their hypercharges. So that is really great. I am kind of regretting getting Colt's hypercharge a little bit, but it's fine. He's really good and, you know, decent in heist. But Spike, Shelly, and Pearl are all really excellent brawlers to have their hypercharges on. So that's my 12 brawlers. That's exciting. We're coming up on 12 months of playing free to play, and we have 12 maxed out brawlers. Now, that's not to say that you can only max out one brawler every month, because I've spent tons of coins and power points on upgrading all these brawlers to power 9 and power 7 and getting all their gadgets. But considering the fact that I have so many more power points than I have coins, that has me thinking that I'm probably not going to be focusing too much on hypercharges. I might just have to settle with whichever ones I get for free for a while at least. Once I unlock Tick, honestly, it's going to be a while between unlocking new brawlers. So I'm not going to be unlocking brawlers very frequently, which means that I will then be able to focus my resources rather than on upgrading new brawlers to power 9. I can now focus on upgrading the brawlers that I like to be competitive. It's kind of an interesting shift in how things are going. I don't know if I'm transitioning into like end game. I'm probably not. This honestly could be seen as like mid game or like late mid game or something like that. It's kind of fun. It's day 322. Okay, this is a big deal. I just open up an epic star drop, which I don't typically show on my videos anymore because usually you don't get anything good, but there's one thing that is really good that you can get from an epic star drop, and I just got it. It's the only good thing. I mean, other than the gold and the power points, which obviously you want. I literally just unlocked Tick from an epic star drop. I was just talking yesterday about how I just had one more epic brawler or super rare brawler to get, and I got it. That is insane. Oh my gosh, look at this. Look at this. All I have left are legendaries and mythics. I literally just got Tick off camera. That is insane. I was not expecting that. Holy cow, that is insane. Okay, cool. Gosh, I don't even have enough coins to be able to upgrade him to power 9 like I usually do. I mean, I do have these 75 bonus rewards that I'll be able to unlock at the end of the season, so I will. Actually, that's going to be plenty for me to be able to max him, or not max him, but get him to level 9. I was just not expecting that. Was not expecting that at all. I never thought that I would get a super rare brawler from a mythic star drop. I knew it was possible, but the odds are like, they're astronomical. I just looked it up. It's a 1% chance. So in 100 epic star drops, I would get a Tick or a new super rare brawler. This is insane. Totally unexpected. And I'm just feeling hyped. That is awesome. I never thought I'd be so happy to see Tick pop up on my screen. As far as I'm concerned, I already had all the super rare brawlers. Tick doesn't exist. Well, that's hype. Today is day 326, and this is crazy. It took a long, long time, but I am finally out of token doublers because of this double token event, and then all my token doublers actually got rid of it. So they changed how many token doublers you're getting from star drops, which is why I had so many, which is why I no longer have a surplus. We're going to open up the star drop, then I want to show you something. And it's not the second star drop, it's something else. It is this satisfying 1,422 star drops. I love seeing that. Also, just yesterday, we got some more lore added into the game, which is exciting. If you're watching this like now, you know what's happening. If you're watching this in the future, you probably already know what happened. But you can enter this time anomaly and, like, start looking at star parks, CCTV or whatever it is. Star Park Security. This is so great. Oh, man. I'm going to be making a Brawl Theory video on this. I don't know when this video will be released compared to a Brawl Theory, but anyway, this is interesting and fun. We just got a couple days left of the season. I've pushed up over 24,000 trophies, which is pretty cool. And that's pretty much my status update.
State 3 of 27. Sorry. Low energy today. Not feeling super great. But we have our 600 coin jackpot, which is interesting because it's only been 7 days since my last jackpot. And I thought it was weird because it had been previously 54 days since the last one. So I don't know what to think about this, honestly. I guess maybe I didn't miss the jackpot. Like maybe I thought that I had. I have no idea. I will happily take the coins though. Also, this is really weird. It looks like I don't have any quests, but if you go in here, you see boss fight. It shows that I have a quest, which is kind of weird. So I'm going to do this boss fight quest, even though it doesn't show that I have one. As I'm doing the quest, it does show that I am gaining towards this. So we'll see if this actually does give us the 500 tokens that we want. Okay, here we go. Completed it. And we got a rare star drop. No surprises there. And we did get the tokens. Very cool. Kind of weird. It is day 239. Feeling a lot better now, by the way. This has actually been up in the shop for a few days, so I'm going to go ahead and grab that just because I'm recording now. Kind of cool to have an animated one for free. That's pretty sweet. More importantly, though, we are at a brand new season, which means the previous season is all over. I ended it with 97 bonus rewards, which is kind of interesting because I had the Brawl Pass, and it wasn't even as many bonus rewards as season 19's, where without the Brawl Pass, I got 124. And, you know, I did run out of token doublers, but I didn't run out of that many token doublers. So I don't know. That's kind of interesting. But we get to finally open them all up and get a bunch of gold, which I desperately need. It's really sad. There's no way for us to convert the power points to coins. And I currently have way more power points than I have coins. I'm regretting spending so many of my club coins on power points when they actually remove the way to double them. There's nothing I can do to go back and change that, but I'm probably going to be in a permanent state of always needing more coins than power points now. So here we go. Spam this open. Grab this. Oh, I actually forgot about the tokens that are, or the credits are going to go towards Meg, which it's not like I'm going to be able to get Meg. In fact, I'm still going to be like very, 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 very far away from Meg, but it's kind of interesting. Now, this next season is going to be pretty interesting, okay? It is the last season before they actually swap the new season system to a 1 month season system. Now, this is going to be really weird because I will no longer be able to use my free gems to buy Brawl Passes. And this next season, I won't even be able to get enough to purchase this last Brawl Pass season. So my goal for this next season is going to be to unlock as many Chromatic Brawlers as I possibly can. I need to unlock Cordelius now because he's going to be a new legendary brawler. Thankfully, I already have Surge unlocked, so that's actually really great. But this is going to be a weird turning point for me because I'm no longer forced to spend my gems on just the Brawl Pass because I can't spend gems on the Brawl Pass. So I'm going to have to find a new way for me to spend my gems to be the most efficient way possible. My guess is that the best way for me to spend my gems is going to be in the shop when special offers come out. But I'm going to be doing some math once I actually have better numbers on the actual like gem to coin value that you can get from various different sources. Once I actually have access to the developer build for the next update, but that's like a whole month and a half or maybe a month from now anyway, so it's not like I can give you any answers right now. You'll have to save that for a future video. But there we go. We have unlocked all of them. You know what? That was actually more credits than I thought it was going to be. It was probably around, you know, 400 something log credits. Oh, it would have been close to 500 because I almost opened 500 or 100 of them and they each gave 5 credits. So that's pretty good. But now I have 10,000 power points and 8,000 coins. And I finally do have enough that I can actually upgrade Tick. So we are going to upgrade Tick up to power 9, like I always do. And I'm going to go with Last Hurrah. Mind Mania is like kind of cool and stuff. It's way too easy to mess it up and not actually get value out of it. Whereas Last Hurrah, you can get value out of it pretty much every single time. So let's go ahead and grab that. And we are down to just under 4,000 power or coins. I'm not going to worry about any of the other stuff. I'm not going to be using Tick very much at all. In fact, I'm probably just going to be using Tick to complete the quests and stuff like that. Which, speaking of, we're at a weird, interesting point on this account. I do have a goal of getting every single one of my brawlers to 500 trophies. That's been my goal for a really long time. But I'm actually unlocking brawlers faster than I'm able to push brawlers to 500 trophies. Now that I have all the super rare and the epic brawlers unlocked, that will change a little bit, except for the fact that they are getting rid of the chromatic rarity. And a lot of these brawlers are actually going to be converted into epic, mythic, and legendary brawlers. I mentioned unlocking Cordelius as fast as possible. Yes, that is going to be a high priority for me. After that, the question is whether or not I'm actually going to be able to unlock a second chromatic
automatic brawler that will be turned into a mythic brawler, because that will actually save me a lot of credits later on. In the long run, it's actually not going to matter because I'm going to have every single brawler unlocked way before all of my brawlers are even close to maxed out. But saving some credits does mean that I'll end up getting more fame early on, which is kind of a flex as a free-to-play player. But it is going to be a while because I am going to have a lot of mythic brawlers remaining to unlock, and they take a while to unlock, which is good because then I'll actually be able to start really porting my resources into individual brawlers, and I won't be at this awkward limbo where all I have are a bunch of power nines and very few maxed out brawlers. And in return, I'll be able to get all my brawlers to 500 trophies. I have a little bit more time to do so. I will admit, I'm a little bit sad that I'm not going to be able to have the gems to purchase this next season of the Brawl Pass, because Charlie honestly seems like a really cool brawler, and I have no idea how long it's going to be before I will even have the option to unlock her. Now, I've been able to push up some mastery on a few brawlers, so we got Dynamikes right there. We got Daryl to rank 3. Shelly's now rank 2. Oh, we got Spike up to rank 3. That's fantastic. Belle's now up to rank 2. Chuck's up to rank 1. That's 1,000 coins. Very nice. And I got some extra power points from the trophy road. We're getting close to 25,000 total trophies, which is pretty awesome. We'll get an extra reward once we get there. And this is the account after 239 days. We've got 54 of the 73 brawlers in the game. That's 74% of all the brawlers, which is pretty cool. They are all level 7 or higher with at least one gadget. Most of them are power 9 or higher, though. We have 12 power 11s, including 4 with a hypercharge that are completely maxed out. And I got plenty of power points and coins, which I will be spending in specific ways that I have plans for later on. For now, this is KairosTime ticking by. We will see you in the next video.